All right, guys. We're at the Apollo Ascent. The true endgame is here. Have you played Shin Megami Tensei 3 then? Protag is in that one, does punches for his physical attacks. I haven't really played much of or any of the Shin Megami Tensei series. Or Persona for that matter. I think the very first Persona game I ever played was Persona 5, right? And I only found out about the Persona series thanks to my wife. So I've never really actually played any of the Shin Megami Tensei series. I do have SMT5. I purchased it when it was on sale on Amazon. I just haven't actually played it yet, you know? I don't know why, I just have it. Actually, I need to make sure I find that too. I have a huge backlog of games I should be playing, but I always put them to the side for like Nintendo stuff. It's a steel bookcase too. It's still sealed in shrink wrap. One of these days I'll unshrink it. Because that's not weird. Matthew touched the statue's forehead. Its hand popped out of the water to give me a hand. I see a foot in the water over there. It's Mythal Siva. It's almost as if they're telling me to go backwards. What? Double Mad Zephyr, Titan Blade! Only 287? That's unfortunate. Fury Demon. Ba 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 bum. Should be able to reach that.
Crush.
Mm-hmm. do as much as I thought it would, right? Still too far away. I guess I could just hit back. Big sneeze. Thank you. My right eye is bothering me. I keep having to blow my nose. I think I'm getting sick. It's so unfortunate. I have to get better by Thursday because I have a test. And I can't afford to miss it. So unfortunate. But what's worse, that now means myself and my wife are gonna be sick. And we still have to try to take care of the baby. We gotta try to do it without getting her up in her face and whatnot. It's hard to do because the baby wants to do nothing but be all up in your face. That being said, it might already be too late because I've been noticing that she's been coughing and sneezing a lot lately. So much energy. Nice try. Matthew's coming up on level 50 soon. Why is this here? Hey, I'm gonna turn the mic off for just a second. had to blow the nose. I had a feeling this was gonna happen, and it did. Oh, wrong person. I was trying to jump over and it wouldn't let me. None of them activated their ability. Wow, for an attack that said Seething Rage builds over, it didn't really do much. I was expecting a whole lot more. Hey, look, it's her finger. Pulling her finger. This place is huge for no reason. The path of light may not be trod without mourning those who pass into shadow. Observe the rites like so. First, bring fire to the deceased's eyes. Then cleanse the forehead with a drop of water. Next, blow a cool breeze across the nose. And finally, walk the path described by the scent of morning incense. Alright, so... fireballs. Hopefully it's not timed. What the heck? Wow. To think that they're gonna make me do this. More fireballs! Now we do douse. Now we got Warren. Just notice the map is in the shape of a skull? Yeah, alright. That's all I was like, you know, this place is way too big. It's a skull with hair. The hair is right over here, right? It's got its hair right here. It is the skull. I gotta do it over? Apparently I did something wrong. Was I not on the path? Or did I go the wrong way? I see what I did wrong. I stepped off the path. Fun, right? All right, so the last Mars Jenny is here. Let's save again. Very important. We'll save again under the second slot too, because we don't need to worry about going back to where Blintz was. Get it right? Take care, man. Thank you, thank you. Thanks for hanging out with me. Rest easy. And yeah. Lots of fluids, okay? Fluids are gonna be your best friend. It's like Gatorades. Drink your Gatorades. Can't go wrong with some Gatorade. It's a mint! Her agility is 669. That is ridiculously high. First one. interesting. Am I too high up? Wrong button. I want to use crush right here. Alright, Crystal, what where this leads? Right? Opens to a Jenny. Oh no, it just leads down there. Useless. Okay, so it was blocking it. I have to leave them where they're at initially and then come back for it afterwards. Alright, now for the water run! A hard nut? A hard nut to crack. So far, it's not bad though. These puzzles are long-winded, that's for certain. I'm not certain why they thought this was a good idea though. sorry. I'm starting to be a little, I feel a little drained. I think this cold might be getting worse. It's starting to make me feel a little drained. I might have to actually end early. Oh. That would be highly unfortunate. But yeah, I might have to actually end stream early just so I can, like, lay down. I really don't want to, though. I once again don't feel like I accomplished much. So it might be we end instead of continuing on after we beat Golden Sun, Dark Dawn. Just because I feel like I really just need to take a nap. I should be close enough to get that while still being able to get away quickly. I thought it wanted me to go down there. I gotta push it all the way back to the other side. Alright, should be, oh no, we got Venus left. I completely forgot about Venus. Jay should be here. The game said Apollo Sanctum Gate. Oh, it's on a higher level? Up there he is. Zephyr's bow. Let's go. Got another weapon? It's actually weaker. Can't get up there yet. So I can't do this though. Have I done enough to deserve that Jenny yet? Alright, we have them all, chat. Every Jenny. Mike's gonna swap Aurora with Fury. I guess you could say technically we're 100% now. Back in time. Not quick enough. Let me see if this is close enough. Nope. I think I got stuck trying to get down. Alright, we got it this time. I'm a monkey, Chet! I'm a monkey! Now I gotta put them all in the center, I think, and recreate a face. Death is the dark reflection of life. To enter, create my dark reflection. Basically, stack all the emblems in the same spot. It's kind of neat how all these actually create a face. I thought it was clever. Now for the hair. And now, chat, we have activated Apollo Lens. We have reached the Apollo Lens. That's safe. This, I believe, is a point of no return. Let's save once more here. Alright. End game. Light here is so strong, you will need protection to survive it. Hemi's prophecy. We must clothe ourselves in shadow, or rather in the Umbra gear. Ah, of course, this is why the Umbra gear is important. Time for Shveta to step into the limelight, or so to speak. This will all depend on you. What am I to do? Well, this equipment is tailored for Morgul beastmen to wear. Sounds like Shaventa's the girl for the job, alright. But why is the gear just for beastmen? The Apollo Lens is the product of cooperation between the Genii and ancient Morgul beastmen. And the beastmen did the physical labor, so they were the ones wearing the equipment. So why is it the Umbra gear? Because if we are to survive the light, we must wrap ourselves in the Umbra. Another word for shadow. Very good, Amity. Amity. And so that is where I must step in? Alright, here I go. Do we really know that the Umbra gear alone will be enough to protect her? There's no way of knowing for sure. I have faith in our leader. Matthew will guide me. Ah, Matthew, of course. You don't think Matthew can do it, Craig? Don't be absurd. Of course I do. Matthew, you've led us well to this point. Now, guys, we're going to do this last obstacle. Once we come out up there, I'll be in danger. Don't let me down, please. While in the brighter spots, pay close attention to the upper gear's endurance gauge. The endurance gauge slowly increases while you are in bright spots. If the gauge goes too high, the Umbra gear will fail and you will be swallowed up by the light. When the gauge is high, hide in a shadow such as by a pillar and let the gauge get lower. When you are in a bright spot, keep an eye on the level of the Umbra gear's endurance gauge. It's hilarious because we're supposed to be having Shaventa lead us around. But it's actually Matthew that's, Matthew's supposed to be leading us around, but we're the ones leading Matthew around. That's what I meant to say. I appreciate how simple this is after all the other puzzles. It looks more purple than blue, but sure. Yo, was that the Soul Blade? Let's go. You have to do it like that, right? It's like pulling the Master Sword out of the pedestal. Da 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 da. They really did build some really elaborate items and gear and stuff. And machines. How did we regress so far that we are unable to create things like this now? But back in the day, they were creating giant structures like this like it was nothing. Oh, the Soul Blade! That's what you need to get to the rest of those places. So if I wanted to now, I can go back and do the extra bosses and whatnot, right? Because we have the Soul Blade now. So should I go back then? Alright, let's save again. So the issue now will be that getting back up here is gonna be a pain in the butt. Retreat doesn't work here. Of course it doesn't. Why would it? Why would the game be easy? Okay, I was afraid it was gonna return me to where I was. There are two bosses that we need to fight. Think, 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 bam! Well, I guess we don't technically need to fight them, but we're gonna do it anyway, right? So that we can say we truly 100%ed the game, right? Man, I wish I had a teleport. A teleport would be really great right now. Radiant fire! Emerald Blitz! Karis is a little bit faster than Himi in terms of swipes, sword swipes. Wait, I have a void. Why am I not just using a void? Do, 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 do. My eye. It stinks up fierce. It's really irritating. I guess I could just use retreat. Our boat is up here. Alright, so we're going to